Hello friends, welcome to GYAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently we have 10 series that target your prelims and one series that target your mains. So these series are targeting the aspirants of 2019. So as you know friends, your prelims is fast approaching, so we are also kind of giving a fillip to our initiative of prelims, and we will now from now onwards maintain consistency in uploading these prelim related MCQs. So in these prelim series, what we do, we daily discuss 10 questions of a particular topic, and in this way two topics are discussed in a day, so total 20 MCQs are discussed. So in a week approximately 140 MCQs are covered, and this amounts to near about 560 questions in a month, and in 4 months you can imagine that this will obviously touch the number 2400. So if you want to be consistent, and if you are targeting prelims 2019, then do follow these series seriously. So let's start our discussion friends, and let me tell you before starting that we will end this series only on 31st May, that is one day before your prelims exam. So in this way, with this video series will be continuing till 31st May. So friends, please do ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and also ensure that you press bell icon, because some students do not watch the complete video. But if you want to subscribe to our channel and want to watch the video later, then you can subscribe to it. So let's start our discussion friends. First question is, Indian Computer Emergency Response Team has been designated under the Information Technology Amendment Act 2008 to serve as the national agency to perform which of the following functions? So first, approving the commercial plans of internet service providers. Second, for forecast and provide alerts of cybersecurity incidents. Third, regulating the mergers and acquisitions of internet service providers to maintain service quality. So let me tell you friends that we have to choose the correct answer. We have to choose that which of the following statement is correct. So let me tell you that only one statement is correct, and that is second. That is, it provides forecast and provide alerts of cybersecurity incidents. The first thing is not done by it, and the third statement, that is acquisitions and mergers, are regulated by the Competition Commission of India, not by this Computer Emergency Response Team. So we have to choose the correct answer. So it is second only. So the answer would be D. Solution is D. So here is justification. So I have already told you that this overseeing of merger is done by Competition Commission of India. So basically this Computer Emergency Response Team of India is basically, it has the function of collection, analysis and dissemination of information on cyber incidents, and it also forecasts and alerts of cyber security incidents, and also it advises on emergency measures for handling security incidents, cyber security incidents, and also it ensures coordination of cyber incident response activities. So it issues guidelines and advisories, vulnerability notes and white papers relating to information security practices, procedures, prevention, response and reporting of cyber incidents. So let's move on to the second question. The second question is, the pressure exerted by liquid at the bottom of a circular container will increase with an increase in. So here we have been asked that the pressure that a liquid exerts on the bottom of a circular container, it will increase with an increase in. A, height of the liquid column. B, width of the container. C, width of the liquid column. D, all of the above. So let me tell you friends that as pressure is force per unit area. So obviously if we increase the height of the liquid column, for example here is, I have included this glass before you, so if this is the glass, if liquid is that much in it, then the pressure will be exerted at the bottom and it will be less. But if we increase the water column, it will increase the height, if we add water, then the same amount of further amount of water will be exerting pressure on the same amount of area. So certainly the pressure here will increase at the bottom of the glass. So in this manner, this height of the liquid column causes the pressure to increase. So A is the answer. Solution is A. So it is, as I have provided you the justification, the force is acting, pressure is what? It is a force acting on a particular surface, on a unit area of a surface. So total pressure exerted by liquid column as its base is proportional to the height of the column. But if, for example, if we can increase the depth, the width of this glass, so bottom, if we increase the width of the bottom, so for example, the width increases by increases like in this much manner, then what will happen in this way, the liquid will be distributed and now the pressure will be exerted on the on a larger area. So obviously that the pressure will be exerted on a larger area, then obviously pressure will decrease because same amount of water will be exerting pressure on larger area, so obviously pressure will decrease. So this is about your second question. Let's come to the third question. Third question is, consider the following statements. A. Men have lower pitched voices than women. Are men's vocal cord is shorter than that of women? So let me tell you, friends, that yes, men have lower pitched voices than women because women have high pitched voices and also including children have high pitched voices. And this pitch is basically depends upon the frequency. Higher is the frequency, higher is the pitch. So men have this pitch is men have lower pitch. And let me tell you that why it is lower, because men's vocal cord are it is larger than women. Why women have high pitch? Because they have shorter vocal cord. So here R is not correct, but yes, A is correct. R is not correct because the vocal cord of men is larger than the vocal cord of women. So A is correct, but R is not correct. So the answer is A. So similarly, children also have this shorter vocal cord. So here is the explanation. So children have very short vocal cords, so why, that's why their voice is shrilling. It is quite high in pitch. So this is the reason behind it. So let's move on to the fourth question. Fourth question is, you are in a populated building that has caught fire and you do not have access to a fire extinguisher device or water. In this case, which of the following is the best course of action? So here you have been given a scenario that, for example, you are caught in a building that has caught fire, and you don't have the availability of fire extinguisher or extinguisher device or water. Then what will you do? Then here the options are A. Spread a mixture of lots of salt and sugar on the fire. B. Release a lot of dry baking soda on the fire. Throw saltpeter on the material that has caught fire. D. Spray a mixture of acetylene and dry air at the fire. So let me tell you, friends, that D is not correct, certainly, because acetylene is a kind of it is an inflammable substance. Obviously, it will increase the fire. And similarly, saltpeter is used in explosive devices. So certainly, saltpeter will also be clearly wrong. So now we are left with A and B, and let me tell you that the answer is B, that is release of a lot of dry baking soda on the fire. So what this will do, it will kind of release the carbon dioxide when it will be close to fire. So this carbon dioxide is the best extinguisher. So that is also, this carbon dioxide is also stored in the red cylinders that you see in public buildings. So basically it is kept in a high pressure cylinder. So it is there in solid form in cylinder. So that is why it is called dry ice also. So B is the correct answer. So because C2 is the carbon dioxide is the best extinguisher, and sodium bicarbonate, that is baking soda, it will release carbon dioxide and it will check the fire. And let's move on to the fifth question. Fifth question is, nanotechnology can prove useful in A. Desalination of water, desalinization of water. Second, wastewater treatment. Third, cosmetics and food packaging. So here we have been asked that in which of the following it is useful. Let me tell you, friends, that it is usable in all of these. It is used for desalinization of water, it is used for wastewater treatment, it is also used in cosmetics and food packaging. So it is a very easy question. So D is its answer. So their nanoparticles are used to convert the contaminating chemical through a chemical reaction to make it harmless. And also there are some commercial applications of nanoparticles like titanium dioxide and zinc oxide nanoparticles in sunscreen, cosmetics and some food products. So this is about your fifth question. So let's move on to the sixth question is, if body weight of a person is given, his body mass index value can reveal his A. height, B. age, C nutritional status, D both A and C. Let me tell you, friends, that the body mass index is used for calculating the nutritional status, and if it is it is it is also used to measure whether a person is undernourished or overnourished. It is underweight or overweight. So it is basically it, when we measure the weight, so it is basically weight divided by square of the height of a person. So if you have body mass index and if you have the weight of a person, then you can certainly find its height, because BMI is equal to weight upon height square. So it is in simple calculation, you can be able to calculate the height, and also you can also tell the nutritional status. Because if you come to know about the height, and if you know but come to know about the body mass index, you have the body mass index, and if it is certain below where it is certain, it is at a level, particular level, it is at the, for example, it is below 18.5, then you can say that it is the person is underweight and its nutritional status is not good. But it is if more than 22, then you can say the person is overweight. So in this way you can tell both height as well as nutritional status. So the answer is D. So here is the explanation. So let me correct myself. The body mass index of 22 is not the overweight, but the body mass index of more than 25 is in actual practice overweight. So this is about your explanation part. So simply, body mass index is calculated by the weight of a person divided by its square of its height, and this is basically about your this question, body mass index question. So let's move on to the seventh question. Seventh question is, genetic engineering can be used to modify. So here we have been asked that in which of the following applications we can use genetic engineering: one, plant cell; second, animal cell; third, microorganisms including virus. So we have to choose the correct answer. So let me tell you, friends, that genetic engineering can be used to modify all these or all these given options. That is, plant cells can also be modified to make them resistant to certain type of insects, pesticides, and pests or weeds, and also to make them drought resistant or make them climate resilient or environment resilient. And also the animal cells can be modified. So they are modified for different reasons. And similarly, the microorganisms including viruses can also be genetically modified. So it is, the genetic modification is nothing but it is the genetic engineering is simply the modification in the gene data of organisms. So solution is D, that is 1, 2, 3. So here is the explanation. So bacteria, let me tell you that, please notice this point, that bacteria was the first organism which was genetically modified. So let's move on to the eighth question. Eighth question is, Tyndall effect can be observed when, first, sunlight passes through the canopy of a dense forest; second, a fine beam of light enters the room through a small hole. So let me tell you, friends, the Tyndall effect can be observed in both of the cases. So Tyndall effect is nothing but it is a scattering of light by colloidal particles, that, for example, water vapor or other dust that is present in the atmosphere. So in this, it scatters, and the scatters the path of light, and thus the path of light becomes visible. So C is correct answer, both 1 and 2. So Tyndall effect scatters a beam of light. So in the forest, there is mist that contains tiny droplets of water, which acts as particles of cloud dispersed in air, and dust and smoke also present in the air can also scatter the beam of light. So in this way, you can see the beam of light in a dark room also, because if that room had the dust. Let's move on to the ninth question. Ninth question is, consider the following about the Agni missile. So we have to consider certain statements about Agni missile. First, Agni 1 is a surface-to-surface missile. Second, this is a short-range ballistic missile which was developed by DRDO of India under the Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. Third, it is capable of carrying nuclear warheads. So we have to choose the correct statement. So let me tell you, friends, that all of these are the correct statements. So solution is B. Yes, Agni 1 is surface to surface missile, and it is short range ballistic missile, and it is solid fuel is used in it, and it is single stage solid solid fuel propelled kind of ballistic missile, which was just developed after the Kargil war to fill the gap between the Prithvi 2 and the Agni 2, because Agni 2 had a range of 2500 kilometer, has a range of 2500 kilometer, and Prithvi 2 has a range of 250 kilometers. So to eliminate the gap between 250 and 2500, this Agni 1 was developed, and it is ballistic missile that is it is guided. Once it is launched, it is guided by the gravity on its target, and also it has a specialized navigation system that helps it in precision attack. So this is already serving the army, Indian army. So solution is B, that is 1, 2, 3. So recently also India had in November month had conducted the night trial of indigenously developed nuclear capable Agni 1 ballistic missile. So now it is operable in the night also. So yes, it is capable of carrying nuclear warheads, and also it is a ballistic missile, surface to surface missile, and it is short range missile. And it was developed under integrated guided missile development project of program of DRDO. So it has a specialized navigation system which helps it to maintain high degree of accuracy and precision. And also it has single stage missile powered by solid propellants. So it was developed to fill the gap between the Prithvi 2 and the Agni 2. So it was developed under the advanced it was developed by Advanced System Laboratory. It is premier missile development laboratory of DRDO. So please keep it in mind, Advanced Systems Laboratory. It is the missile development laboratory of the DRDO. So it can carry payloads up to 1000 kg. So please remember this also. It is important, sometimes UPSC asks this type of question also, that how much amount of payload this missile can carry. So this has a capability of carrying 1000 kg of payload. So it has been already serving the Indian Army. So let's move on to the 10th question. 10th question is, recently India designed India's first indigenous microprocessor called Shakti. Second, Indian Institute of Madras researchers have designed and developed it. Third, it has been developed under project partly funded by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. So we have to choose which of the following is correct. So let me tell you, friends, that all of these are correct. Yes, Shakti is the first indigenously developed microprocessor, and it was developed by IIT Madras, and the project was partly funded by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. So what would be the benefit of this? Obviously, now we are developing our own microprocessor, and if we are using our own microprocessor in communication systems, or for that matter in defense technology, then certainly we will be less vulnerable to cyber attacks, because always imported microprocessor has reliability issue. So that thing will be eliminated. Obviously, it will enhance our national security, and also it will promote the security of our communication satellites or other things, or communication systems. So solution is D. So this is all about, friends, today's video. So explanation is about Shakti. It was developed by IIT Madras recently in November month. So project partly funded by MEITY. So it will reduce the dependence on important microchips, and can be used in mobile computing, wireless and networking systems. So friends, this is all about today's video. If you like the questions, please like it. Please share it with your friends, and if you have any suggestion, then please tell me in the comment box. I will certainly consider your suggestion. So lastly, let me tell you, friends, that those students who want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, they can contact us at our contact number that is given here, that is 8968426481, that I have highlighted, and also they can contact us on our email, that is achieveias21@gmail.com. So if you want the PDFs of these daily MCQs, then you can contact us at this number, because ultimately at the end of the day, you will not be able to see 20 to 25 minute long video, and also at that time you will have to revise multiple topics, multiple subjects, and you can't read standard books or for that matter NCERTs, because these things can be read only at when you have leisure time. So at the time of exam, you must do the revision, and at least revision should be 4-5 times, and that revision can only be done by an innovative method, and not by following standard books or for that matter NCERTs, or by seeing videos. So these MCQs have been designed in a manner that they can help help you in revision of multiple concepts in a comprehensive manner, because explanation is given there and you are told why a particular option is correct and why others are not correct and in which context they will be correct. So in this way, each question covers your four concepts and you will be able to cover your syllabus in a comprehensive manner. So if you want to subscribe to these PDFs, then you can do WhatsApp us at this number or you can mail us at this email ID. So certainly it will entail certain cost, because so obviously, friends, we have to sustain ourselves. If we are not getting anything, then we will not be able to maintain the consistency. So for the purpose of consistency, for the purpose of motivation, we will certainly charge certain amount, but it is the minimum that we will charge. So if you want to get these PDFs, you can contact us at this number. So this is all about, friends, today's video. If you liked it, please like it, share it with your friends, and also, friends, please subscribe to our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon. So thank you, friends. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.